With the end of the Second World War and liberation of India from British rule, a new paradigm shift in the economic policy of the newly liberated largest democracy of the world was imminent. Within this new republic, the state of Assam sought to play a leading role in formulating its own economic policy on the backdrop of the traditions of a several thousand-year-old kingdom that was called the Pragjyotisha or Kamrupa. The whole of Assam was waiting for a pioneering Assamese economist who would hold the torch in formulating a modern economic policy for the growth of Assam by assimilating the ancient wisdoms of the old Assamese civilization. And eventually, from the first generation of Assamese economists, Principal Bhabananda Deka came forward to begin his systematic and scientific research on the economy of Assam by authoring the first ever Assamese language book on this core subject with the title Akham or Arthanite in 1963.
Hoytokam Akahor Pora Bohu Durot আৰু বহু দূৰত তোমাৰ শেষ কবিতা য'ত আছে পোহৰৰ ৰেখা সত্যৰ জ্বলন্ত সত্তা.
Principal Bhabananda Deka and legendary musician filmmaker Dr. Bhupen Hazarika had been lifelong friends and intellectual partners. Just as Dr. Bhupen Hazarika highlighted the cultural aspects of Assam across the world, Principal Bhabananda Deka highlighted the intellectual aspects of Assam. Here is some footage from a documentary film shot almost two decades back by award-winning filmmaker Dr. Bhupen Hazarika. As editor of the famous Assamese journal, Atma Prote Nidi, our representative, filmmaker Dr. Bhupen Hazarika persuaded his close friend Principal Deka to become a contributing author. But Principal Deka never liked to talk about his own life and instead let his work speak for themselves. Both these friends loved to talk about Assam and its heritage and the cultural and philosophical traditions which had been enriched by the cult figure in the domains of literature, art, culture and social transformation, namely Srimanta Sankardeo.
Hey Homoyot, Bharatat Gorleutha, Navavishnav, Bhakti Andolanor, Bibhinna Dik, Phohiyai Saisi, Porjalasana Kurisil, Dakhinaitar, Hankarasarjar Adwaitabad, Eibar Hakolo, লক্ষ্য করি আর বারো বছর কাল বিভিন্ন ঠাই ভ্রমি বিভিন্ন সন্ত মহন্তর লগত আলোচনা করে শঙ্করদেবে এটি পুষ্ট মন ল বদরিকাশ্রমত প্রথম অসমীয়া বরগীত রচনা করে আলিপুখুরীর কাখর বরদাত প্রথম নামঘর নির্মাণ করে ভক্তি ধর্মর পাতনি মিলে.
Principal Bhabananda Deka was an extraordinary scholar whose intellectual pursuits influenced the trajectory of Assam. He thrived to explore the heritage of Assam in its different dimensions and compiled his research into 115 books. His books in English and Assamese covered the broad topics of Assamese literature, heritage, culture, anthropology, art, philosophy, economics, education, politics, religion and archaeology, giving a very candid view of this part of the globe. He started his intellectual journey from the early 1960s, envisioning a planned modern society with structured economic growth by writing both serious research papers published in leading Indian research journals, as well as essays published in leading newspapers and journals. His command over the topic of Assamese economics, as well as Indian economics, had been acknowledged across India. He was acknowledged as a pioneering Assamese economist who paved the way for systematic study and research within a historical context. At the same time, the general Assamese readers also bestowed upon him the honour of being the leading Awahon Randenu, era litterateur of Assam.
অসমৰ অৰ্থনৈতিক নানা ধৰণৰ প্ৰবন্ধ আমি দেখি আহিছোঁ, সেই প্ৰবন্ধ পাতি এতিয়া সংকলন পাঁচ কবিতাৰ অসমৰ অৰ্থনৈতিক
He had been the only distinguished economist to be acknowledged and honoured as a leading litterateur, which is a rare and unprecedented recognition to an economist from Assam. Principal Bhabananda Deka was also a leading educationist and was the only Assamese to enter the principal offices of six different colleges scattered across the Brahmaputra Valley, including two postgraduate institutions in Guwahati, which is not only the capital of Assam, but also the trade and cultural hub of northeast India. His administrative abilities were also duly acknowledged by the government of India when he was invited to the Indian capital of New Delhi in the 1960s to officiate as a government officer in an Indian constitutional commission, which selected the top Indian bureaucrats in the country. During his brief tenure as a top-ranking bureaucrat, he played a pivotal role in establishing the Assamese language departments in UPSC as well as Delhi University. This was one of the first official successes of propagating Assamese language and literature outside the state of Assam in its entire history of civilization. He also helped to organise the first ever event associated with Assamese literature in New Delhi in 1969 on the occasion of the birth centenary of Assamese writer Zahitya Roti Lakshminath Bezbaroa. He managed to convince two Indian presidents, Dr. Zakir Hussain and Fakhruddin Ali Ahmed, and two prime ministers, Indira Gandhi and Morarji Desai, not only to personally attend the events, but also to write about their impressions in the form of tributary articles acknowledging the Assamese language.
He tried his best to be the master of all discipline of Assamese language. And he
After returning back to Assam, leaving behind his top bureaucratic garb in the Indian capital city, Principal Bhabananda Deka rejoined his favourite job of teaching to undergraduate and postgraduate students and also reconnected with the local villages and indigenous tribal communities by extensively travelling across Assam, both in the plains as well as the hills around the entire Brahmaputra Valley. During those memorable trips, he managed to collect many precious materials and data relating to the traditional rural and tribal economy, on which he conducted lifelong research and published many research papers and books in the later years. Exploring the local people's social, intellectual and cultural life became his lifelong passion. His path-breaking research on the long-forgotten Hadrong community of northeast India and Bangladesh was recognised by the intellectual circles, and he had been acknowledged as a leading authority on this community.
আমার বাপুজি কলেজ পাঠতেই আমার আলোচনা হল ডেকাক আমি প্রিন্সিপাল করলে ভাল হয় ময়ে চাইজ করি যদি আহে যদি ডেকা আহিলে ভাল হয় আর তেতিয়া রাজেন ডেকা আছিল আমার কলেজের সম্পাদক আর ভবানন্দ ডেকা তেখেতর এজন প্রিয় ছাত্রও আছিল আর সকলে অন অল একট মানে ডেকাক সাপোর্ট করলে ডেকার যোগাযোগ করলে আর তেখে প্রিন্সিপাল আহি আর আহি ইয়ার দুটা বছর আছিল আর সেই দুটা বছর কলেজের বিল্ডিং হওয়া নাছিল আমার হঠেবের স্কুলতে পুয়া পুয়া ক্লাস হয়েছিল।
Having witnessed poverty and illiteracy among the rural populace of Assam from the pre-independence days under British rule, which continued even after Assam became an integral part of a free democracy, Principal Bhabananda Deka brought the wealth of education to the doorsteps of the underprivileged rural population. With a selfless missionary zeal, he not only established the first high school in the same satra-attached village where he was born, but also brought in all the facilities of higher education to the vast hinterland around that village by establishing the first undergraduate and postgraduate college and offering his full-time service as the principal for several years in order to give it a strong footing. In later years, he spread his wings across the entire Brahmaputra Valley, being instrumental in setting up many institutions of higher learning, which still bear his mark as a legendary educationist and knowledge propagator.
যে অসমৰ বিভিন্ন দিশত এটা আন্তঃসমূহীয়া গঠন কৰা বা গঠন কৰিবলৈ প্ৰয়াস কৰা এইগৰাকী ব্যক্তিৰ যিখিনি অৱদান সেই অৱদান সাম্প্ৰতিক কালত যিধৰণে প্ৰচাৰ প্ৰসাৰ বা আমাৰ মাজত সমাদৃত হ'ব লাগিছিল
Principal Bhabananda Deka was born in Litterateur, a historical Assamese institution, and raised in his early childhood in the monastic tradition of simplicity, in the Litterateur tradition founded by the middle-aged saint, philosopher and artist, Srimanta Sankadev. This heritage made him a lifelong follower of Assamese Vaishnavism, and he devoted his entire life in conducting research on Vaishnavite literature, philosophy and art, authoring many books and presenting research papers. He realised the urgency of projecting the classical literature, philosophy and art of Srimanta Sankadev and other Vaishnav saints to the outside world in order to provide a glimpse of a very modern, democratic, progressive social and intellectual lifestyle advocated by these saints during the Middle Ages in the 15th and 16th centuries. Just before his death in 2006, he completed the translation of the Assamese classic holy book, Kirtangosa, originally written by Srimanta Sankadev. He also took the pains of offering individual biographies of these saint philosophers, both in English and Assamese, so that the entire world could be made aware of their contributions.
দেখি মই কৈছোঁ বোলে নহয় এনেকৈ থাকিলে নহ'ব এইবিলাক গোটেইখিনি নষ্ট হ'ব গতিকে তুমি অলপমান ভালদৰে ইয়াত সংৰক্ষণ হয় তেতিয়া আমাৰ নিজৰ বুলি নহয় গোটেই অসমৰ ৰাইজৰ এটা ভৱিষ্যতে এটা উন্নতিৰ মানে অৰ্থনীতি হওক বা সাহিত্য ক্ষেত্ৰতে হওক বা জীৱনী ক্ষেত্ৰতে হওক অসমৰ এটা উন্নতি হ'ব
Principal Bhabananda Deka was instrumental in making the first documentary film on Srimanta Sankadev, and his works in the fields of drama, poetry, music, dance, art and social reformation. The film was screened in the US, Canada and other places in the year 1997, and a copy had been preserved in Switzerland. The film, for the very first time, highlighted to the rest of the world the rich cultural and literary traditions unique to Assam. The whole of Assam and India rightly acknowledged the social and intellectual contributions of Assamese economist Principal Bhabananda Deka. The Golden Jubilee of the first ever book in Assamese on Assam Economics was celebrated by the Assamese public, and several leading intellectuals also paid tribute. Local Assamese media had also been eloquent about his contributions to the formulation of a strong scientific economic policy for building a modern progressive Assam which valued equality, fraternity and brotherhood amongst all ethnic groups and communities in Assam. All concerned well-wishers of Assam would look forward to the ushering in of such an Assam in the footsteps of the dream stitched together by this pioneering Assamese economist.
আৰু তোমাৰ চাউল খোৱা নদীৰ পাৰত আজিও বহিছে তাত সভ্যতা সংস্কৃতিৰ হাত সাৰ পাই উঠিছে ইয়াত কাৰ্বি হাজং ৰাভা বড়ো গাৰো মহিমূৰ কৰিজাত পাত জিলিকিছে নিৰঞ্জনা আইতাৰ ৰঙচুৱা ওঠ